Hello onliners, welcome to my YouTube channel guys, welcome everyone. On this channel, I talk about everything exciting, but I try to focus on technology, business analysis, project management, and affiliate marketing. My name is Julian Elao, and I am excited about the internet and all the tools that it offers, and especially the tools that are there to make our lives just a little bit easier. I spend most of my free time on the internet trying to research, you know, ways that we can, you know, use to help us on a daily basis. Now, in this video, I want to talk to you guys about online opportunities. Of course, I'm an onliner and I'm aware of many things that have happened on the internet. So I want to talk to you guys about what opportunities are there online for individuals that don't have opportunities as yet. How do you become a freelancer? How do you start freelancing? In this video, I want to focus on, you know, the people or individuals that are out there that really don't have opportunities as yet. You know, you are a graduate or you are unemployed and you have specific skills, but you are just not aware of the opportunities that are there for you, especially on the online market. Now, if you are already employed and of course, you know, you have a company that you work for on a full-time basis, 8 to 5, of course you need to honor your contract obligations and then make sure that, you know, you focus on that. So freelancing is not for everyone. I am aware of the opportunities and I just want to share it with people that, you know, that can make use of the opportunities. So you need to ask yourself the question, what exactly am I good at? What exactly am I good at? Which skills do I have that I can use? Are you perhaps a good writer? Are you a good designer? Can you proofread a document? Or can you work as an online tutor or, you know, become a virtual assistant? You need to ask yourself the question, what exactly am I good at? Channel guys, so today I want to focus on three things. I want to focus on explaining to you guys what freelancing is, how does one become a freelancer, and then where do you start. So number one, what exactly is freelancing? You come across, you know, people and they are saying, but I freelance, you know, or I'm a freelancer, I work as a freelancer. You know, what exactly is it that they do? So guys, so freelancing is when you apply your skills, your expertise, your knowledge, your experience of things that you know, things that you have learned in life from your past, you know, working experiences or things that you have learned on the internet or things that, you know, you taught yourself how to do. If you have certain skills, you know, of, you know, things that you can deliver, you can use those skills that you have and become a freelancer. So what freelancers do is they provide specific services to multiple clients, and freelancers can take on multiple assignments at the same time, of course depending on whether they have capacity to do so. So really a freelancer is just, you know, someone that goes on a freelancing platform. Now there are so many platforms, but today I'm going to focus on one freelancing platform which we will talk about, you know, in the later section. So what a freelancer does, they go on the freelancing platforms and then they create little jobs. So they call it gigs. So they create little work packages of things that they can deliver or things that, you know, they can work on. So I would go, for example, in a platform and then say, I am able to translate a document for you from Spanish to English or from English to Spanish. You know, and I'm able to do it within 3 days. If it's, you know, you give your specifications, so I'm able to do it in 3 days, you know, if it's a 3-page document, you know, for example. So you go and specify your gigs or your, you know, work packages of things that you can deliver. Now the same platforms, they are, you know, people that are looking to to buy into, you know, what you are delivering. So, you know, people are out there looking for people to, you know, proofread their documents, for example. So you are going to outline what exactly it is that you are able to provide. So, for example, you will say, okay, I'm able to, to design a logo for you within 3 days. And this is how much a logo will cost if I deliver it in the next 2 days. So really, a freelancer just uses what they know to provide services to, you know, multiple clients, and they can provide services to multiple clients. So really, guys, it's a flexible approach, and it works for people that, you know, some people are doing it on a full-time basis, some people are doing it on a part-time basis, you know, depending on whether their companies allow them to do. So I'm just putting it to you guys out there so that you are aware of the opportunities, and we'll talk about the platform, you know, in the upcoming session. So really, in a nutshell, that is what freelancing is. It's a flexible approach of working. Most freelancing happens on the internet. So if you have, your internet connectivity and a laptop, you can be a freelancer, you know, on any of the freelancing platforms. So really a flexible way of working. You don't have to report to anyone. You just need to have capacity and be able to deliver the work to the clients as you say that you would deliver it. So that is what freelancing is. So freelancing is for everyone. There are no specific requirements to say you need to have studied, you know, that specific course to become a freelancer. Like I've explained before, freelancing is really about applying the skills that you know, applying the skills that you have, you know, things that you are able to do. That is what freelancing is about. So there are no specific requirements to say, only specific people can work as a freelancer. So if you are able to provide specific services, you should be able to work as a freelancer. So really, guys, it's for everyone. So if you are a scholar, for example, when you are at school and you have some free time, out of school, you can become a freelancer. Or if you are in university and you are just completing your studies and, you know, after hours, maybe you have some free time, you can become a freelancer. Really, it's a flexible approach. You just need to, deliver what you say you can deliver. If you're a graduate and you are looking for opportunities out there and you just can't find any at the moment, you can become a full-time, freelancer. I know a lot of people that freelance on a full-time basis and they don't work for anyone. All they do is freelance, Now, if you have a job, you have a company and you are employed on a full-time basis, of course, you need to make sure that, you stick to your contract and that, I guess you don't freelance at all, depending on what your contract say. What some companies do, they make you declare the type of work that you get yourself involved. So if you are okay with, or your company is okay with you freelancing, after hours, or freelancing over the weekends, really up to you. You can still just go ahead and do that. But really depending on, if you are allowed to do it or not. If you don't have any, obligations and you are not working for a specific company, you can definitely freelance on a full-time basis. It's flexible enough. You do it at your own time. You just need to specify to your clients, the number of days that you are able to deliver the work that, they are asking you to deliver. Of course, when you are freelancing, you specify your own rates. And specific companies also have, rules and regulations according how things needs to be done on specific platforms. And I'm going to take you through one of the platforms called Fiverr. It's a freelancing platform. And so I'll be taking you through on how you can, become a freelancer on Fiverr. Now, to answer the question, yes, freelancing is for anyone. I think you only need to be 18 and above. Of course, there are specific things that they test, when you become a freelancer. So, for example, if you are saying, I can translate your document for you from, English to Spanish. Of course, the platforms need to make sure that, you are able to do what you do. So there are certain skills that, of course, you will be required to prove that you have. So there are tests that you take, So like if you are saying you are able to translate from English to Spanish, of course, then, if you you need to take up an English test, for example, to prove that, in your English, is definitely up to you know, a specific level. So all those things, guys, really no specific requirements. It's just certain things that you need to know. Make sure that you pass on the platform and that you know you can go ahead and then carry out the tasks that you know you carry out. So really available for everyone. Very, 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 it suits people that don't have anything to do at the moment. You can freelance on a full-time basis. I personally don't freelance. I use Fiverr for to get most of my work delivered. But again, I am aware of the opportunity, so I'm just putting it out there for you guys that would want to become freelancers and want to do it on a full-time basis. Really, opportunities are there. You just need to go and create your gigs. We call them gigs on the platforms, on the freelancing platforms. So you just need to go and create your gigs of things that you are good at, and then, you know, put it out there. You know, clients will see you, and you will never know, you will start, you know, providing services to these clients, and maybe you might never actually work for anyone. So guys, freelancing is available for everyone. I would do it if I didn't have, you know, a full-time job. So really, if you don't have an opportunity, and this is the reason why I said, you know, in the beginning of my video, I am focusing on people that, you know, don't have opportunities as yet, and really they are not aware of the opportunities that are there out for them. Google, what is freelancing? There are so many platforms that would come up, you know, that you can take advantage of and then start freelancing. In this video, I'm going to focus on Fiverr as a freelancing platform. So in my next section, I am going to take you guys you know, through Fiverr. So I am going to answer the question, where exactly or how exactly do I get started?
So where do we start, guys? I'm sure you're asking yourself the question, where do I start if you want to become a freelancer? So there's a freelancing platform that I want to introduce you guys. The platform is called Fiverr. So this is where all the freelancers meet, you know, and all the clients that want to buy into the freelancing services. So really, as you can see, it's a user-friendly platform. Straight to the point, and as you can see, all the services have been listed, so you just need to figure out what your skills are and then which services to bid for. So of course, the first thing you need to do is you need to make sure that you have an account, first of all. So I already have an account, so as you can see, I already logged on to Fiverr. So you need to go right ahead, and then, you know, there's a link in the description below. You need to click on the link and then create an account. Make sure that you create an account. It's an easy process, guys. So you can connect, you know, using your Facebook or your Gmail, and then just go right ahead and then make sure that you have an account created. Now, once you have an account, you'll be able to log in, and then you will, you know, log on to this platform here. So this is what you will see. So for you to become a seller, you need to apply to become a seller. So on your dashboard here, you know, you can just click on become a seller, and then, you know, apply to become a seller or a freelancer, you know. So of course, you'll have to go through some steps. So you just have to click on continue. So guys, I think here they're just telling you how important it is to do certain things on Fiverr. So you really need to take your time. It's not a process that you need to rush through, because remember, people that are looking for freelancers are going to, you know, scroll through your account, and then they are going to make sure that it is professional enough and, you know, you have the skills that you are saying you have. So it is really important that you take your time when you are creating the profile on Fiverr. So you need to prepare your content. You need to prepare your pictures, your profile picture that you're going to use. And very important, you need to add accessibility, guys. So you will be required to link some, you know, professional networks on your account, you know, things like your LinkedIn account, your blog, if you have, you know, professional social media networks like your Instagram accounts, Or if you have your personal website, anything that is professional that you can link to your profile so that you know people can go on those professional networks and then actually see your experiences that you are talking about, what it is that you are doing, and so forth. Also very important, guys, is that you describe your professional skills as detailed as possible. So there is a description box where you need to detail all your professional skills. Make sure that you list all the skills that you have and that you don't miss out on anything. To be honest, the more the better, guys. People need to understand if you are capable of doing certain things when you are bidding for the services. And then very important, guys, you need to have a picture and put in effort, you know, into getting a picture that is, you know, professionals, you know, something that people can look at and really say, okay, at least we are working with someone here. So really important, guys, don't just go and put any picture, you know. You need to think through these things and then make sure that you know your profile is professional enough. So then you just go right ahead and then you click on continue. Of course, there are some certain, you know, community standards that, you know, Fiverr asks you to adhere to. So like you must not provide misleading or inaccurate information about your identity. So when you are signing up on Fiverr, guys, make sure that you know your identity, your the names and the information that you are providing is accurate, you know. I would say use the same information that is on your ID, you know, because this is really important, because when you start working on Fiverr and then you start, you know, getting your payments from your gig, you won't be able to receive these payments if your identity is not correct. So you need to make sure that everything that you do on the platform really is accurate. This is important because, you know, and especially in terms of payouts, it's really important that you make sure that your information that you are providing as accurate as possible. Also, another important item is the way you communicate on Fiverr. You are not allowed to give clients your personal information. You know, what some people do, you know, they trick their clients into giving them their, you know, email addresses or WhatsApp details. Now, that is not allowed. All communication needs to happen on Fiverr because, you know, nobody is going to be accountable if your money goes missing or your client does not pay you and so forth. So, of course, you need to make sure that you follow these standards and that, you know, any communication about payments on Fiverr, you know, needs to happen on Fiverr. So, you are not allowed to have duplicate accounts at all. So you need to create your gigs. You need to have one account, you know, which identifies you, and then you need to create your gigs on that specific account. So certain things that you need to make sure that you follow, guys. So when you click on continue, you should be able to fill in your information, have a picture. As you can see, my profile is, you know, my description and profile is empty because I don't really use Fiverr as a seller, like I said in the beginning. So you must go right ahead and then make sure your personal information is completed, your professional information is completed, you know, and you put in all the information that is required. Make sure that you link your accounts, your professional networks accounts on your Fiverr. And then make sure that you hear your completion rate is 100%. Make sure your profile is well completed. Now, once that is done, you can go right ahead and then you create your gigs on Fiverr. So I'm just going to try and see if I will be able to show you the process of creating gigs. All right, so let's just see. All right, so as you can see here on the dashboard, you have gigs. So these are the, you know, work packages or jobs that you can create. So you can just go right ahead and then you say, you know, you create a gig. So you are creating a job. Okay, so I'm not allowed to create a job because I'm not a seller as yet. But on your end, if you become a seller, you'll be able to create a gig and publish it. So you can create a gig. So what you do when you're creating a gig, you are just going to outline your services that you can provide. So you will say, I can translate your document for you from Spanish to English. Or you can say, I can, you know, proofread the document for you in one day, you know, whatsoever services that you are able to provide. And then, of course, you'll be able to list your rates, how much you're going to be charging. Normally, it comes, you know, per hour, or you charge a fixed rate. You can specify all those things in your gig and how long it can take you. You can go on other people's pages or other freelancers' pages, and then I just want to give you an example to see if I can go on, you know. So for example, here, I will create a beautiful book cover design for you. So if you go on this freelancer's profile, you can see the specified, you know, different types of packages. You can go for the basic package, you can go for the standard package or the premium package. So they put in a description, e-book cover only, you know, higher resolution. You can have three revisions done, and then three demo cups. It will take 7 days to deliver, and then you can have three revisions. Okay, and then the deliverables here, you will have one design concept, a back and spine design, and then one source file, and then a mockup. So if you want to, you know, go for the any of this, you know, packages, whether a standard, basic, and premium, you can just already specify your prices. And then, you know, when a seller, I mean, when a buyer comes, they can just continue. Or they can contact you, you know, they can chat to you and then just say, hey, I would like to have my book designed. You know, you just give your specifications here and then you can send. I'm not going to send them a message now because they will receive it and I don't really have work for them. So you need to specify your, you need to specify your gigs, you know, so that when sellers come here, they can specify their project, what it's about, and then give you, you know, specific instructions, and then of course upload the relevant files. And then, of course, define their budget. So you can say you are agreeing to that or not, and then accept the gig once you know you agree between the buyer and yourself on the way forward. So that is just what the platform is about. It's really just about you know, defining your gigs and then putting it out there. Take time to play around. Take time to create your profile and then play around with the, you know, with the platform. And then see, you never know, you might just get yourself opportunities out while you are at home waiting for, you know, local opportunities. Keep yourself busy with things. I mean, competition is tight. Of course, everyone is on Fiverr and there are people that you know really have very good profiles. So in life, it's always difficult to start, you know, but once you get started, you will grow your profile slowly by slowly and, you know, you'll get there. So I think that is it on my end. Make sure that you get yourself a profile, you know, use the link below and then, you know, get a profile.
Thank you so much for watching the video, guys. Please subscribe. Please subscribe. Make sure that you don't miss out on any of the videos coming up. There is so much content that I'm going to be covering. And if you love the internet and everything technology like me, make sure that you don't miss out on any of the upcoming videos. Thank you, guys. If you are out there looking for opportunities, make sure that you become a freelancer. I left the link in the description below. Please click on it and make sure that you have an account on Fiverr. I see you guys again. Ciao.